Welcome to Simplify Studies. Today, we will learn about Qutb-ud-din Aibak, the founder of slave dynasty. Qutb-ud-din Aibak was a slave and his childhood name was Aibak. He was sold at a very young age to a Qazi, but later was bought by Muhammad Ghuri. Muhammad Ghuri was very kind towards his slaves and used to treat them like his own children. Qutb-ud-din Aibak was intolerant towards Hindus, but he was very generous towards his community. So they used to call him Luck Baksh, as he used to distribute lakhs of money. In 1206, Muhammad Ghuri died and his military commander Qutb-ud-din Aibak took over the charge and declared himself as Sultan. Because of this, he is regarded as the founder of slave dynasty. The early rulers of this dynasty were called Mamluk Sultans. Mamluk is an Arabic word which means owned. Since these sultans were earlier slaves of Turks or were sons of the slaves, they were called Mamluk Sultans. Qutb-ud-din Aibak strengthened his position by forming matrimonial alliances with influential rival Turkish chiefs. He married the daughter of Yalduz. Next, he got his sister married to Nasruddin Khwaja of Sindh and got his own daughter married to Iltutmish. Qutb-ud-din Aibak laid the foundation of Qutb Minar in Delhi in memory of Sufi saint Khwaja Qutb-ud-din Bakhtiar Kaki, which was completed by Qutb-ud-din Aibak's son-in-law Iltutmish. As Qutb-ud-din Aibak died in 1210 while playing polo, his son Aram Shah succeeded him in 1211 but was overthrown by Iltutmish. And finally, Qutb-ud-din Aibak's daughter Razia Sultana became the first woman ruler of Delhi Sultanate in 1236. That's all for today. Have a good day.